Carter family take care of the rest of the night. But I just want to start out tonight by saying we're glad you're here. Every one of you, and some of you are already working hard bringing visitors. So thank you for bringing visitors. If you have offering, it'll be Boys and Girls Podcast. We'll tell you more about it. And when you come in, we'll make sure you come in with your sunglasses and dressed up like a detective. However, you'll get points. They'll share more with you. If you're here every night this year, you're going to get extra points just for being here every night. And so we want everybody to feel like they can win the contest, bring visitors. So let's pack the place out, get lots of people to come. We're glad for the Carter family being here, and we're really glad for each one of you being here. Hey, listen, we want to have a really good time. I want you to laugh, and so we're going to tell them bring it tonight. When they see the puppets, they're going to be fun. You're going to make them laugh, right, Brinley? Yeah. Right, Bella? Yeah. There's going to be puppets. But most of all, we want you to know at the end of the night that God loves you. He wants to work in your life. And so we're looking forward to everything that Carter's got for us. Like I said, invite your friends. Come back every night. Tomorrow night, Wednesday night, Thursday night. Let's just have a good time. Let's open up in prayer. Let's everybody be real quiet. Let's pray together. Let's ask the Lord to help us tonight. All right? Pray with Pastor Seville. Father, I love you and I'm thankful for your faithfulness. God, thank you for your presence that we already sense here tonight. God, thank you for the liberty that we know that we have in spirit. God, thank you for each and every young person. And I pray that God tonight that each one of these young men and women will walk away knowing that you love them. And God, you can keep them from a life of sin. You can give them peace and you can give them joy. God, you can give them purpose, a destiny that you have for them. So God, I pray that you would fill them up with your spirit tonight. That you would watch over the Carter family as they minister. God, bless them for their efforts. Keep them in your health and strength, God. Protect each one of us throughout the week as we travel, God. Lord, I pray that most of all, that tonight, throughout this week, the dedications to God will be made in the lives of young boys and girls that will change their entire life. God, be glorified in everything that's said and done. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Well, welcome to Kids Crusade. Aren't you glad? Amen. To be in Kids Crusade tonight?
Yeah.
Let me hear you.
Yeah.
All right. Welcome to Sleuthing for the Savior. Anybody know what a sleuth is? I didn't say a sloth. That's what some of you did on summer vacation. Slayer. Sneaking around looking for clues. So we're going to be sleuthing for the Savior this week.
Right. So we need you guys to be sleuths. We need you
right.
To be
investigators.
Right. Got your
thinking cap on. Mm-hmm. Be every night. We're going to have a new case. And tonight, our case is, so we have to remember it, our case tonight is who broke the rules. Did you do it?
Oh, no, these kids aren't
going to
break the rules.
I hope they don't break the rules.
We're detectives.
That's right.
This week to be detectives.
So that's what we're trying to find out tonight. Who broke the rules?
So keep your thinking caps on and your eyes peeled open to search for clues.
Right.
And who broke the rules? But you didn't even tell them what our names were.
Oh.
And introduce ourselves.
My name is Inspector Joe Hartley. Inspector Joe Hartley, and this is my sidekick, Detective Francie Drew.
Right, so we are here to investigate cases in God's Word.
That's right.
So we're glad that you came. We need some help. Can you
That's
stand
right.
up?
Let's all
we're
stand.
Gonna
we're going to sing our theme song.
Song every
we're
night.
We're going to start out every night with this. Do I have young man, but you make an ugly girl. All right, we got an 8-year-old girl. 9-year-old girl. Come ahead. Do I have an 8-year-old boy?
9-year-old boy? All right.
Okay. It is no mystery. The clues are there to see. So read the posters and sing with us.
Put your hands together.
Thursday night, whoever has the most points gives some Oreos.
actually raise your hand. Raise your hand if you want to say something. And then we'll pick you. But other than that, try. If it's an emergency, you got to go to the restroom, that's fine. But try no running around.
Right.
Running in and out.
Because you might miss something really
absolutely
cool.
Absolutely.
So you want to go into the bathroom before we start.
That's right.
And now we're going to talk about the other contests.
The offering contest.
Water balloons. They know the drill. Win this year, girls, and we are going to throw water balloons at Joe. Bothers things and everything, so So I have to follow the rules around this place because Joe gets really upset if I don't. But I don't really see that big of a deal why I can't lay my coffee cup over here on the desk. Why would I want to carry it around all the time? So I'll just finish dusting and it's not going to be that big of a deal. Do you guys like to dust? Y'all like to dust?
No, not really.
Do you? Oh, wow. Oh, that would be great because dusting gets on my nerves. That is probably my least favorite thing to do. Why? It takes a lot of work. Oh, ah!
Joe!
judgment time?
We're going to have to do something.
Would you forgive me, Joe? I shouldn't have broke the rules. I shouldn't have obeyed.
Yes, of course, Francis Drew. I forgive you. But just like these papers were once white and not wrinkly, now they're all dirty and crinkly. That's like our heart. When we break God's rules, it's no longer clean and pure, but now it's ugly and yucky because of disobedience and sin.
I know, my heart does feel bad. Not only did I break Joe Hartley's rules and I put my coffee mug on the table, but I broke God's rule too in the Bible. What did I do? I lied. So I broke your rule and God's rule, Joe.
I think maybe you need to ask God to forgive you because I forgave you.
I'm going to ask the Lord to forgive me right now. Dear Heavenly Father,
Lord, help
I'm sorry that I broke Joe Hartley's rule, but I'm really sorry that I broke your rule and lied. Please forgive me of that. Please wash my heart clean and make me all whole again, and my heart to be white, not stained. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So now, Joe, my heart's not stained like that.
Well, that's good. You know what? Just can this piece of paper get out of that stain by itself? No, it can't by itself. And we can't get our heart clean by ourselves. No. It takes Jesus Christ. But right now, it's going to take Francie Drew to go to some of these papers.
Oh, I hope you get around in time. All back up. This is crazy. I should have never broke those rules. You know why, Joe? I probably listened to the devil's tempting about me laying the coffee up there breaking the rules. Because this morning I was so busy I didn't even take the time to read my Bible and pray.
You didn't pray this morning.
3:23.
For all have sinned
and come short of the glory of God.
All right, guys. You guys ready only to say it?
Just the guys?
Let's see
how well the girls, just guys
can say it. Are you ready? Romans 3:23. For all girls have sinned and come short. Guys, are you ready to say it right this time? All right, Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
That was right that time. I didn't either. Girls, you think we can do a better job than that?
Get it?